today's video, I want to start off by telling you that I've been pretty nervous about doing today's video. I've been excited, but I've also been nervous, and the reason is because my biggest concern had been that I have way too many brushes and I was like, this video is gonna go on forever and people are gonna get bored, and I didn't want that to happen, obviously. So I thought about it. I think I've been thinking about this video seriously for the past 3 weeks, and I decided that I would split my brushes into categories. And these are not all my brushes that I have like laid out in front of me right now, but they are like either my favorite ones or my go-to, like, you know, sometimes when you go, your hand just picks that one up first. So I've split them into 7 categories, and 7 categories. And let me not make this video any longer. Let me dive right into this, because I want you to understand how I use my brushes, where my brushes are from, why I use my brushes the way I do. Yeah, let's just dive right in. Okay, so the first category I have over here is the most quintessential, classic, everybody has to have it kind of set of brushes. These are a bunch of my stippling or buffer brushes. The reason they're called what they're called, of course, is that they all have like a lot of volume. They're very dense and they're very stiff. They're not like, let's say, something like this, which is so easy to move around the hair off. They're more stiff. They're more, you can use them for pretty much anything, from your foundation to your concealer, your contour, your bronzer. But at the same time, the products you use need to be more face driven, like you can't use these on your eyes. I've picked up these brushes from different places. I haven't maintained the body of them in the nicest way, so please don't judge. Also, a lot of the brushes you'll see are brushes I've used either yesterday or today and definitely need cleaning. So let's just get that out of the way to begin with. These are cleaned as well as brushes that need cleaning. I've got this from BS Mall. I picked it up from Amazon. You will see a link of this in the Shop With Me highlight on my Instagram feed, as well as I will add links to whatever I show over here today down below in the info box. This is my Morphe one. I got this 104 buffer brush from Zoeva. This is also from Morphe. It does really well for literally anything and everything. I've used this for blush, I've used this for bronzer, I've used this for foundation. Pretty much everything does really well with these brushes. I mostly land up using these stiff bristle brushes for my foundation. But then of course, if they're slightly looser, like this one over here, I might even use them for my bronzer and contour. Next, I've got the more loose hair category of face brushes, like the ones I have over here. Now, typically I would use these with powders, all of them. But this one over here, this is a brush I picked up from Zaful recently. If you guys have seen my Zaful video, you will recognize this. I actually saw someone online using one of these long brushes for like a liquid foundation, and I thought that it was worth a try. And it's actually doing really well, which is surprising, because I would normally not use such a long hair brush for foundation, especially with how loose it is. I've done my foundation today with this, so it's worked out pretty well. The foundation I'm wearing today is the Body Shop Liquid Foundation. This one over here is like my compact brush, my go-to brush. Literally anytime I feel like something needs a little more blending, I just pick this brush up. It's a full face brush and it's really, really soft. This one is from e.l.f. And this one over here, a couple of you guys have asked me about on some of my videos before and on Instagram DM. But I want to tell you, I don't recognize the name of the brand at all. It just says Ocean. I think it's just one of those regular brushes that I picked up from a local beauty store near my house. It's really not branded. And even though it has like a couple of hair coming out from like different sides, it performs really, really well. So it's sort of lasted years with me. Of course, you have to clean your brushes regularly, but I think that if you know how to clean your brushes properly and you have the right set of brushes, you're good to go. Next up, I have some eye brushes over here. Now, if you notice, all of these are very different from one another. This one is more like round. I would use this on the outer corners. I have literally used this right now on the outer corners to add dimension. It's very rounded. You could also use it for just diffusing or blending. And then these two are more angled and have a flattish, end to it right on top. This one is from Morphe. This is from my BS Mall kit that I talked about a few minutes ago. And these two over here are from Zaful. This last one from this category is just a really nice rounded one. It has really long hair, so I haven't actually been able to use it very well for concealer or eyeshadow. But something like this would be nice if you're into like small highlighter brushes, like really tiny ones, or just for different purposes. I feel like one of the things that I've learned to overcome in my head is this feeling that certain brushes are meant for only certain things. No, round tip brushes or just regular face brushes like these can be used for anything and everything. I could also probably use this for blush, like There's no rules to it. I'm constantly saying that to you guys only because I believe in it so much. There are only very specific brushes that are meant for very specific things. I will pick them up next. These are the two brushes that I think have very specific purposes. Like, I can't even imagine doing anything apart from concealer with this brush. Maybe just going into the deepest inner corner of my eye. Okay, so as I was saying, sorry, my camera battery died and we had to swap cameras. So in case you see a slight difference, I'm really sorry about it. But let's talk brushes now. So like I was saying, these two are very, very specific in nature. Because of the conical tip of this one, I really can't imagine using this for anything apart from the innermost corners of my eye. I feel like concealer is the only and the main product I use this brush for. I'm not complaining at all. I have a lot of multi-purpose brushes. So it's absolutely fine to buy a couple of really nice, good investments that you know will do very well for a particular product. Next up, of course, I have this brush over here, which is unfortunately not doing very well for itself. Considering it's new and it's only like a week or two old and I've barely used it 4 or 5 times, I'm not very happy with how the ends of it are turning out. I picked this one up from Zaful, but at the same time, when I do use it, it does a really good job. So I'm not complaining from the performance point of view, but more from like the sides. But coming to the shape of it, this is why these two are pretty specific in my opinion. Moving on to category that I think is category number 4. It's really nice to have a few flat brushes at hand at all time. I feel like you could use these to pat down or just to apply your eyeliner in general, like these ones over here. You can see this little blue one over here that I recently used. These brushes would also work really well to go over your lower lash line if you don't have something that's slightly rounder or softer. Apart from which, I know I use this one a lot to clean out my excess product to give this little sharpness to the eyeshadow that I personally like every now and then. So if you have flat brushes, don't think that you would use them only for your concealer or only for your eyeshadow. Mix things up. You can always clean your brushes up and reuse them in multiple ways there too. Next up, I have a few other face brushes. These are also long hair and sort of loose. I juggle between my blusher and highlight for these two over here. Occasionally, I have also used this one over here, which is a little smaller than this one. This one is from MAC. It's MAC number 129. The shape has gone a little bad. It was a proper round when it came to me, so I think that's just a usage thing, I'm guessing. Actually, I don't think it's a usage thing. I think when I left it to dry after I washed it, it sort of took the shape of the flat mug I left it in, but it came perfectly fine and it still works perfectly fine. I love MAC brushes. Like, I love, love, love MAC brushes. And this one over here is one of those, again, local drugstore ones that I picked up way long back, but it does really, really well. So like I was saying, I use this sometimes for a highlighter, I use this sometimes for blush, but what I've also used this a number of times for, because it's sort of flattish, like it's not round. I've also just sort of used this to go over with powdered contour, powder, bronzer all over my face to set a cream product or a liquid product in. It does really, really well. So I feel like if you have brushes like these, which are sort of, again, multi-purpose, these are great investments to make because you can use them for different things. The last category, but I promise you it's not the least. I feel like this is a brush category that I recently earned a lot of respect for. It's something that I would not touch earlier, but now that I'm doing all these new different types of eye makeup looks, it's coming in super, super handy. These smaller eyeshadow brushes, or you could use them for other things also, completely okay. Concealer, tiny spot detailing, face art, all of that is fine. I use these for eyeshadows mostly. These really small, really cute brushes come in super handy when you want to go in only on your crease line, or when you want to touch that innermost corner. You'll notice that while this one is slightly flat, there are also like these pointy tip ones which work really well for that absolute innermost corner of your eye. So if you're looking for like a pro look, I feel like the small eyeshadow brushes should not be neglected, because you will get that full look only when you can touch all areas of your eye and your face, of course. Okay, so I hope I've covered everything. There are of course a lot of brushes from here that you can totally skip if that's not a step that you normally do, or if that's something you only do when you're just going out for a shadi or during the festive season. But this is what I use on an almost regular basis when I'm filming my tutorials for you guys. If you have any specific questions with regards to your brushes, let me know what they are down below in the comment section. I hope I've done a decent job of explaining what brushes work how for me. I'm not saying that this is the only way you can use specific brushes. Please feel free to make your own rules along the way. I know I have. Don't forget that before you go away, I would love if you hit that subscribe button so you keep coming back for more videos. Turn that bell icon as well so you get those alerts when I upload new videos. I will see you guys in the next one. I love you.